going to play for each other. And I think when you do that, it's pretty tough to be beat. But Portland's a heck of a team over there, and it's going to be a battle.
Cuts in, snaps the shot off a stick, rolls one, they score! Gives away for 10, in front they score! Ty Ratty, short-handed goal. Cuts in, gets around Sonder, Ratty, wrap around, score! Two shorthanded goals for Ty Ratty. It's 2-1 for Bjorkstrand, step shot. They score! Oliver Bjorkstrand just gets it through for a small. It's 3-1 Portland. Here's a chance, they score! Ty Ratty, the hat trick goal in 4-1 Portland. Zone, here's Lear, empty net, he's gonna bury it. And Taylor Lear ends this one, 5-1 the Hawks lead, and the Portland Winterhawks are gonna win the Western Hockey League title.
Well, that first year that I was on the team, we made the playoffs, which was the first time in modern franchise history, which was pretty cool. But the year after that was a struggle, and all the fans know that, and all the guys here know that. And it's been nice, you know. You appreciate it more, I think, when you've had a season like that, and then you win the league. I was pretty fortunate to play 5 years for the best organization, I feel, in the league, and I couldn't have asked for, you know, any more help, or they just did everything for me that I could have wished for. You know, I feel like you build lifelong friendships, and you know, it's been the best 5 years of my life so far.
There's a lot of great memories with these guys, with the core group of guys that we've had for the last 4 years. A lot of people that have helped me, you know, my family has always been real supportive. My dad, you know, none of this would have happened without him. Coaches that come to mind, we met Triple A Midget coach, which kind of got the ball rolling with my career, be Dale Grayson. He did a lot for me, and Mel Pirano of the Beardies Blackhawks gave me the real opportunity to show what I can do, and gave me the opportunity to play here. My game plan after this, it's going to be a lot of thought into what I want to do next year. I obviously still want to be playing hockey. School is something the WHL offers. Not my first option, but in all reality, it's probably the safest one. Keep my options open. I have to make a decision in the next month here, so I have to put some thought into it and you know, see what I want to do.
Just getting traded here was awesome. I was really excited, and right when I got here, the guys were so good to me. So it was a really good time when I first got here, and then obviously the playoffs was quite a ride. Even when I wasn't playing in the finals, it was pretty amazing, and just such a great group of guys that every day I was here was special.
You know what, Rucker and Foss, obviously they've been with us for 3-4 years, and I think Foss has been here 5 years. So it's you know, from where they were 4 years ago with a 16-win season to going back-to-back championships and winning one of two of the finals. Says a lot about those two kids, what they've given to us and as players and in the dressing room. And obviously bringing Trevor Cheek in, didn't get a chance to play in the finals, but he fit right into our dressing room, and that was a big part why we traded for him. So you know, it's hard for those kids to move on, but they're moving on to the next phase of their life and the next phase of their career. It's a successful season for us, 51 wins in the regular season, and going to the Western Hockey League Finals again. Obviously, not winning the championship hurts, but you know, going back-to-back Western League Finals says a lot about this group of kids. And we've got a lot of kids graduating this year and moving on, and it opens up the door for the kids coming in next year and for some of our younger kids to step up and flourish and you know, continue this culture that we've set in place here. We have high expectations of making the playoffs every year, and once you get in the playoffs, you never know what could happen. And obviously, you know, you got a good nucleus coming back. You got Curtis Lazar, you got Tristan Jarry, and you got Henrik Samuelsson. So you've got a good base to, you know, obviously to be a solid team next year.